Today we shall discuss about the consideration and guidelines for site selection. When we are looking for a place for wind turbine, engineers will consider some factors, wind hazards and characteristics of the land that affect wind speed, and also the effect of one turbine on nearby turbines in wind farms. The three factors they will consider: wind hazards and characteristics of the land that will affect the wind speed, and also the effect of one turbine. Okay, the following important factors need careful considerations. Means first is a hill effect. Here, when it approaches a hill, in hilly areas they will install the wind turbines, the wind will encounter high pressure because of that wind that has already built up against the hill. What they are saying means hill effect. What is that hill effect means? When it approaches a hill, wind will encounter the high pressure because of the wind that it has already built up against the hill. This compressed air rises and gains speed as it approaches the crest or top of the hill. The installation of wind turbines on hilltops take advantages of this increase in speed. That is what they are saying, the advantage in, if we install in hilly areas or hilltop, in hill, they are saying that advantage, it increases the speed. Okay, this compressed air rises and gains speed as it approaches the crest or top of the hill. The installation of wind turbine on hilltops take advantage of this increase in speed. Next is the roughness, or the amount of friction that earth surface exerts on wind. Ocean have a little roughness and a city or a forest has a great deal of roughness, which slows the wind. And next is a tunnel effect. What do you mean by tunnel effect? The increase in air pressure undergoes when it encounters a solid obstacles. The increased air pressure causes the wind to gain speed as it passes between. Okay, they are saying that the tunnel effect here, the increase in air pressure will undergo when it encounters a solid obstacles, for example rock, like that. The increased air pressure causes the wind to gain speed as it passes between. Next is the turbulence. A sudden change in the speed and also the direction of the wind will cause the wind blowing over natural or artificial barriers, that is called the turbulence. Once again I repeat, sudden change in the speed and also the direction of the wind that is caused by the wind blowing over natural or artificial barriers, that is called the turbulence. Here turbulence will cause not only fluctuations in the speed of the wind, but also it will cause the damage to the turbine. Okay, the turbulence will not cause it will cause not only the fluctuation in the speed, a variation in the speed, it will also affect to the turbine also. Turbines are mounted on tall towers to avoid what? To avoid turbulence caused by a ground obstacles. Variation in wind speed. During the day, wind will usually blow faster than they do at the night, because the sun heats the air, setting air currents in the motion. They are saying that during day, air speed will be fast. Wind speed will be faster than at the night. In addition, wind speed can differ depending on the season of the year also. Depending upon the season also, wind speed can differ. Wake. What do you mean by wake here? Wake means, usually in Kannada we say echara. Okay. But here, energy can neither be created nor be destroyed as wind will pass over the blades of the turbine inside. Okay. as it passes wind passes to the blade of the turbine will seize much of the energy and it will convert to mechanical energy. Whatever the energy it received, it will convert to mechanical energy. The air coming out of the blade sweep has a less energy because it has been slowed down. Whatever the air coming out of the blade is, it has a less energy because its speed is reduced. It has been slowed. Okay, the sudden change in the speed makes the wind turbulent, a phenomena called wake. A sudden change in the speed that will make the wind turbulent, that phenomena is called a wake. Because of wake, wind turbine in wind form are generally placed about the three rotor diameters away from one another in the direction of the wind, so that the wake from one turbine does not interfere with the operation of the one behind it. Just you need to remember, the as wind passes over the blade of the turbine, turbine will seize much of the energy and it will convert into mechanical energy. Whatever the air coming out of the blade, that will get it has been slowed down. If the sudden change in the speed will make the wind turbulent, that phenomena is called wake. Because of wake, only wind turbines in the wind form are generally placed about the three rotor diameters away from one another in the direction of the wind. Wind obstacles means trees, buildings and rock formations are the main obstacles in the installation of the wind turbines. Any of these obstacles can reduce the wind speed and also it can increase the turbulence. Wind obstacles like tall buildings will cause a wind shape which can reduce the speed of the wind and also the power output of the turbine. This is about wind obstacles. Next is a wind shear. It is a difference in wind speed at different heights. Okay, it depends upon height also. When a turbine blade is pointed straight upward, the speed of the wind hitting its tip can be, for example, it is a 9 miles per hour. But when the blade is pointing straight downward, okay, when the blade is pointing straight downward, the speed of the wind hitting its tip can be 7 miles per hour. When it is straight upward, it is 9 miles. When it is straight downward, it is 7 miles per hour. This is the difference places stress on the blade. Okay. Yeah. Too much wind shear can cause the turbine to fail. Some following guidelines can be followed to evaluate site for the installation of wind turbines. The turbines work best when on high and exposed sites. Coastal sites are especially good for wind installation. Town centers and highly populated residential areas are usually not suitable sites for wind turbines. They are saying that town centers and highly populated residential areas, you can observe there is a they will install the wind turbine outside the places, okay, where people are not there, okay. Buildings will not be available at that places, only they will install the wind turbines. Town centers and highly populated residential areas are usually not suitable for this, okay. Avoid roof mounted turbines, as there is no guarantee that these devices will not damage property through vibration. And the further and the distance between the turbine and the power requirement, the more power will be lost in the cable. Distance between the turbine and also the power requirement, it should be somewhat less, okay, the more power will be lost in the cable only. If we increase the distance, the more losses will occur between the turbine generation and also the power requirement. The distance of the cabling will also impact the overall cost of the installation. And next is the turbulence disrupts the air flow that can wear down the blades and reduces the life cycle of the turbine also. It is recommended that installing a turbine may be considered only when the distance between the turbine and the nearest obstacle is more than twice the height of the turbine. I already said about this. We have discussed about that, okay? How much distance it should be, you can observe here. 2 times of H, okay? 2 times of H. That is what they are saying. They are saying that when you install a turbine, we should consider the distance between the turbine and also the nearest obstacle. It may be a tree or a building, like that. Okay. The nearest obstacle, it should be twice the height of the turbine. Okay. Twice the height of the turbine, or when the height of the turbine is more than the twice the height of the nearest obstacle. This is a important consideration while installing. Okay. Small turbines require an average wind speed of 4.5 meters per second and to produce an efficient level of electricity. And if site is in a remote location, connecting wind turbine to the national grid will be very expensive, and it may be worth considering an off-grid connection instead of using a battery storage. Next is here 5 important characteristics. Wind speed, that is the startup speed, is the speed at which the rotor and blade assembly begin to rotate. Startup speed means here the speed at which the rotor and also blade assembly begin to rotate. Okay. The cutting wind speed is the speed when the machine begins to produce power. Cutting wind speed means the machine will begin to produce power. And the design wind speed is the speed when the windmill reaches its maximum efficiency. And the rated wind speed is the speed when the machine reaches its maximum output power. One second. This is a here. This is the characteristics, that is a, you can observe, I think. This is the characteristics: cutting speed, rated output speed, and cutout speed. In next slide, I will explain. Okay. Here, startup speed is the rotor and blade assembly will begin to rotate. Cutting speed means the machine will produce power. And the design wind speed means the windmill will reach its maximum efficiency. Rated wind speed is the speed when the machine reaches its maximum output power. For example, it can produce a 1 kilowatt, means it has reached 1 kilowatt. Okay, the wind power generation has reached 1 kilowatt. The falling wind speed is the speed when the machine falls to prevent damage by high wind speed. This is a power curve. You can observe that is cutting, rated, and cutout speed. The cutting, rated, and cutout speed. Generally, that is the wind turbine generators are designed to work at maximum aerodynamic efficiency between cutting and rated wind speed. That is, machine will start producing. Cutout means machine will stop producing. That is what? Cutting and cutout. Okay. For wind speed higher than rated and lower than cutout, blade pitching or blade stalling is used to maintain loading within the equipment waiting. WTG, that is the wind turbine generators, will shut down for wind speed higher than the cutout speed to avoid excessive mechanical stress. Here is the cutting speed means minimum wind speed at which the wind turbine will generate usually usable power. Okay, cutting speed means machine will start producing power. Cutout speed means machine will stop producing. Okay, cutout speed, wind turbine ceases power generation and it will shut down. Cutout speed means rated speed means at wind speed it will be, that is the power output from a wind turbine increases as the wind increases. So here the output of most machine levels of above the rated speed. Most manufacturers provide graphs called power curve, that is how their wind turbine output varies with wind speed. Here rated speed, how much we require rated speed. Okay, if it increased more than that, we should stop that. Okay, capacity versus number of blades. For a given efficiency, a wind turbine with large capacity will run at a lower speed. What is the lowest RPM? RPM is nothing but revolution per minute. A single bladed revolution per minute. Okay, one revolution. That is one revolution per minute. A single bladed turbine can make without losing its efficiency drastically. That is, it is a 60 RPM or one revolution per second. Why? Because it should sweep all rotor area in 1 second. If turbine rotates slower than this, if it turbine will rotate slower than 60 rpm, then it will miss some air particles and its output power will be low. If it rotates faster than that, then it will produce more power, which is better. But faster rotating blades will create a more stress on overall structure. Now, one bladed turbine should run at highest possible safe RPM. High number of blades. A two bladed turbine can run at lower speed with high efficiency. This is because while one bladed sweeping one half of the circle area, the other blade is sweeping the other half. For example, if it is two blade, then if it is other one blade will be sweeping half of the circle area and the other blade will be sweeping the other half cycle. By using same analogy, a three bladed turbine can run much lower speed with a higher efficiency. The low speed turbine increases the cost of electrical equipment and higher number of large blades will increase the wind turbine and civil structure cost. A techno-economically viable option is essential here. Wind turbine performance is affecting wind turbine performance. Here, blade design. Efficiency of a large turbine blades are close to the aerodynamic optimum for steady uniform winds. Unsteady and non-uniform wind conditions cause blade section stall, degradation of wind turbine performance. Wind performance, what are the factors? The main factors will affect wind turbine performance means blade design and noise issues with the local community. For example, that is wind turbine noise increases due to unsteady inflow conditions and also flow interactions from support structures or wakes from the other wind turbines. This is the main issues. Next is the materials. How the blade is, either it may be wood or it may be fiberglass or it may be a composition metal, okay, steel metal. First, wood. Wood is a, it is a strong, lightweight, cheap, and abundant, flexible, and also popular on do-it-yourself turbines, solid plank, laminates, veneers, composites. Next is a blade construction fiberglass. It is a lightweight, strong, and also inexpensive, good fatigue characteristics, variety of manufacturing process, that is a cloth over frame, pulsation and filament winding to produce pass. Most modern large turbines use fiberglass. Blade composition metal. Steel, if they use steel, like it will be heavy and also expensive when you use steel blade. If we use aluminium blade, it is a lighter weight and easy to work with, and it is expensive, subjected to metal fatigue. This is about manufacturing blades. The blade mold is lined with a layer of fiberglass. Yeah, then it is injected with the epoxy resin to enhance stiffness. Here, a layer of wood is also placed between the layers. They are saying that the blade is molded. They are not kept straight. Okay, it is molded. That means it can be, the shape of the blade is molded. It is lined with the layers of fiberglass. Then it is injected with the epoxy resin to enhance stiffness. It is to enhance the, to increase the stiffness. A layer of wood is also placed between the fiberglass layers. Here, two molds are joined and adhered together using a special liquid epoxy, which evenly joins the two sides of the blade. And the finally, the whole mold is baked like a cake. For example, after batter, we will put in a one bowl and we will keep in a cooker or here, that is a oven. There will also, it will, the whole mold is baked like a cake for 8 hours at 70 degrees Celsius. Okay, this is about the manufacturing blades and also materials, regarding materials. Okay, in next class we shall discuss about the geothermal energy.